Welcome back to Snippet Coder, and we're going to start series of videos for streaming radio application. And we are going to introduce 6 episodes of this series. And in the episode number 1, we will cover UI part. In episode number 2, we'll cover JSON downloading and saving into local storage using SQLite. And at episode number 3, we will cover provider state management in detail. In episode number 4, we will cover SQLite integration with UI. In the episode number 5, we will cover favorite screen and search box integration. And in the episode number 6, we will do the final integration of the audio player by using provider state management. In this episode, we will cover the UI part, and we will divide the UI into multiple sections, and it is app logo, search bar, list view. And in the list view, we will create the template for the radio item, and we will have also create the now playing template, and we have a bottom navigations. We will create our home page template, and we are using the bottom navigation bar over here. We will create as a stateful wizard. We will create one private variable over here, that is int current index, initializing it with 0. And then we will create one more private variable that will be final list widget children's. And then we have new text page 1, new text page 2. Basically, we are using that widget over here for our navigator bar. Now we'll create the widget over here, return new safe area. Basically, we are using safe area to avoid any padding issue in the status bar and all. Then we will have child. We are using scaffold here. And for the body, children current index, bottom navigator bar, bottom navigation bar. Then we are providing the background color here, hex color. Then we are providing a type of the bottom navigation bar. We are using bottom navigation bar type is equal to fix. Then we are providing a selected item color. Hex color. We are using white color here. Basically, we are using show unselected label is equal to false, because if the at bottom navigation tab is not selected, we will not show the label over here. Current index is equal to current index. Now items. And here we will provide the bottom navigator items, and for that we will create one private method, bottom nav item. We are providing the parameters of icon data, icon string title, So now we will create one private method of bottom nav item. What we are doing here is we are providing a parameter of icon, then title, and we are making as a generic method so that we don't need to rewrite the code again and again for bottom navigation bar item. And here we will just provide it as a items, and we will provide the bottom nav item, then we will provide the icon over here, icons dot play arrow and title. First tab will be a title of listen, and we will create one more tab, bottom nav item, icons dot favorite, and title will be favorite. Now we will provide a method of on tab. On clicking on that tab, we will create one more method over here, on tab trap. And what we are doing here is on clicking on any tab, we are changing the index of that current tab. So basic layout is ready. So let's see how it's look in the device. So now we can see that bottom navigation bar is coming on the device, and we have two tabs. One is, first one is listen, and second one is favorite. When we click on the first one, we are able to see page 1, and when we click on the second tab, we are able to see page 2. And if you see the code that we have provided, and that children private visits list, and there we are providing first item as a new text page 1, and the second one is a page 2. So once we move to the further coding, and then we will provide a page name over here, and upon clicking on that tab, we are able to see that pages. So our basic template is ready. So now we will create one more template for radio items for using in the list view. So before doing that, we have to create one model file over here, radio dot dot. So we are creating a radio model file, and in that file we having a ID that will be of a int type, and we have a radio name which will be of a string type. Then we have a radio URL that which will be used for that listening to the music and all, and we have a radio description which will be of a string type, and then we have a radio website if any, and then we have a radio pick that also be of string type, and then we have a one more parameter that will be of is bookmark. When we do the functionality of that bookmark, then we will use that parameter. So now we will create a template which we can use in that radio page. We will be making it as a stateful wizard. In this template, we will provide the radio model as a parameter. Now we will create one widget over here, and in that widget we will use the list title. We are making the one widget over here and name it as a build song row, and we are using here list title, and there we are using title with a text widget, and we are providing a data over here, this dot widget dot radio model dot radio name. Then we are styling it with a bold, and we are providing a color with a hex code. Then in the leading we are providing that radio pick, and for that we have created one method also. We will go to that method also. And for the subtitle we are using that radio description over here, and we are using the max line of 2. And in the trailing we are providing that play button plus that add to favorite button. For that also we have created few widgets. So we have created one image widget, and what we are doing here is we are making a container, and in that container we are using a clip art rectangle, and we are also providing the height and width, and we are using decoration box decoration, and we are providing the border radius, and we are also using the box shadow. And here in the child we are providing the image.network, and we are sending the parameter URL of that radio pick. Now we will create that build play stop icons. We are using the icon button over here, and we are providing the icon, and that is play a circle field, and on press we will cover that on press in the later videos, and when we integrate that audio player with our UI part. We are just creating a UI part right now. So we have another widget that will be a build add favorite icon, and we are providing the icon of favorite with the border, and you can see here same for the play also, and also on that on press we are providing. So a template of is ready. We now have to return in that build return build row. So now we will create one page that will be a radio page. So now we will create a radio page, and for that we have to mention radio page dot tag file, and we will make as a stateful widget radio page. And we will make it radio model over here just for showing the dummy data to see how our template will look like. So what we are doing here is we have created one class that is radio model class, and there we are providing a data of ID and radio name, then radio description and a pick of the radio. And we have created a widget of container, and with that container we are providing that column widget, and in there we are providing a children of two template which we have recently created, that is radio row template. So now we will use that radio page in our home page by replacing that new text page one with the template name, that is radio page here this way. So now when we go to that tab one, we will able to see that radio page over there now. So here the template is coming, which we have recently created. The image is coming here. Then we have a test radio one, then test radio description. Then we have a two buttons, that is play button and a favorite button. Image is getting loading from the network, so image is a bit heavy, that's why it's taking time. So now when we click on the favorite button, we are able to see that page number 2, and when we click back to the tab 1, we are able to see that templates which we have created recently. And now we will create one more template that will be of now playing template, and in which we will show the currently playing radio in the bottom of that our screen. Now playing template.dat.file, we'll make it as a stateless widget. This template will be exactly same as our radio row template. Only difference is that we will showing that now playing text instead of that radio description over, and also we are showing that stop button and plus one sharing button, so that if anyone want to share the radio to any of their friends or anyone else, they can do easily. We will create one template that will be of now playing text. So what we are doing here is we having a parameter of context, and then we have a title, then we have an image URL, and that we are providing a list title, and that list title we are providing the name of that title, and then we are providing a subtitle which will be a fix of that now playing. And then in the leading we are showing that image of that radio, and in the trailing we are showing two buttons, one is of stop and another one is a sharing button. For the image we will use the same method which we are creating in our radio row template. So we have a two widgets, and that will be a build stop icon, and there we are providing a stop icon, and another one is a sharing, and we are providing the sharing icon over here. So in the trailing we are providing those widget, that stop icon, and another one is a share icon. So now what we are doing here is we are using a single child scroll view, and we have to make that now playing in the bottom of the page, bottom of the screen. And here we are providing a children of now playing text, we are providing a context, and we are also providing that here we forgot one thing, we have to pass two parameter over here. So we have to provide a two parameter, one is a radio title, another one is a radio image URL. So our now playing template is also ready. Let's put it in the radio page to see how it will look in the device. We will provide a radio title that will be a now radio playing, current radio playing. Then we will provide the image. I will use the same image over here, radio image URL. So this is how it will look like. So once we have the list view ready, then it will automatically come in the bottom. So now we will add the app logo and the search bar over there. So we have created one container over here, and we are using that text color, and we are providing a height of 80, and in the child we are just passing that text widget instead of that image, and we are making the name as a radio app. Now we will pass that in the template, that is app logo. Now see how it will look. So here the logo part is coming, that is radio app. Now we'll add that search bar. So what we are doing here is we have created one container with a padding of 10 but horizontal and vertical 2, and margin of vertical 10 and horizontal 15, and we are using the box decoration, and color we are using the white, and for border radius we are using circular 10, and for the child we are using a row template over here, and in the children we are passing that icon, that we are using a search icon, and then we are making that flexible template flexible widget, and there we are passing that text field, and we are making the cursor color as a black, and for the decoration input we are using border as a none, and for content padding we are using 5, and for the hint text we are using the search radio, and we are also providing one spacer over here. So now we call that search bar. Let's see how it will look in the application. So here our search radio is coming, and above that we are showing that radio app icon. Instead of icon we are using that text. So now we will create one list view so that our UI part will be completed in that way. Now we will create one more template, that will be of radius list, and in that we are using the list view. Currently we are not dealing with any database, so we will pass a static data over here. So what we are doing here is we are using the expanded over here, and basically expanded is used in the list view so that if we have a multiple record we will get the we will not get any scrolling issue at all. And in the widget, in the children we are using the list view dot separated. In the item count I am just providing a dummy data of 10. In the physics we are providing a scroll physics, and for the smooth scrolling and all. And for the item builder I am returning that radio row template, and there we are providing that model class which we have created above as a sample data. And in the separator builder I am returning that divider over here, so that after every row there will be a divider. And for that padding we are using from left to right and to bottom. Now we will call that widget. So instead of calling that radio row template one by one, we will call that radio list view. So now see how it will look in the application. So here you will see that we are able to see the list over here, and with that dummy data, same data is showing because we are not providing any separate data for each row. We are providing the same radio model class for each row, and now you will be able to see that now playing is coming at the bottom. So whenever we click on any of the radio, and then our now playing will show, and when we do the final integration that part will be covered. So that's all in that UI part. So in the next episode we will cover that JSON downloading of that radio data from the server and saving into the SQLite, and that SQLite data will be shown in the application. So stay tuned, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, like, comment and share the videos. Thank you all, bye bye.